Hello everybody, LuigiFanQuadra1 here once again, and it's time for a Mario Plush Collection update. So, let's begin. We'll start off with the Sané Mario Party 5 line, starting off with the Mario Plush. Sané Mario Party 5 Luigi. Sané Mario Party 5 Princess Peach. Sané Daisy Plush. Sané Rosalina Plush. Little Buddy Donkey Kong. Technically Sané, but distributed by Little Buddy. Speaking of Little Buddies, here's Diddy Kong, distributed by Global Holdings, but also a Sané plush. Sané All-Star Collection Toadette. A Little Buddy Birdo. Sané Yoshi's Island DS Green Yoshi. I have three, but each has its own story. This one is the main Yoshi I use now. I bought it from a thrift store for only $2. This Yoshi is the first Yoshi plush I ever got. And this Yoshi I got as part of a set. Sané Yoshi's Island DS Blue Yoshi. Sané Yoshi's Island DS White Yoshi. I have four of them, and this one in the back is very old, and he has a very flimsy neck because as a kid, I always pretended he was dry bones. Thank goodness that didn't happen. Here's the Sané Yoshi's Island DS Yellow Yoshi. I have two. Sané Yoshi's Island DS Black Yoshi. I have three. Sané Yoshi's Island DS Pink Yoshi. I have two. Sané Yoshi's Island DS Red Yoshi. I have three. Sané Yoshi's Island DS Light Blue Yoshi. I have three. Sané Orange Yoshi. A Sané Mario Party 5 Yoshi plush. BDNA Green Yoshi plush. Little Buddy Purple Yoshi. Little Buddy Black Yoshi. Sané Green Yoshi plush. This one was made for the new Super Mario Bros. Line. Global Holdings Yellow Yoshi. Global Holdings Pink Yoshi. Little Buddy Light Blue Yoshi. Vic Tokai Green Yoshi plush. Global Holdings Blue Toad. Global Holdings Yellow Toad plush. The older Sané Mario Party 5 Toad plush. Two Toad plush from Universal Studios. We have the Pit Crew Toad and Chef Toad. Kelly Toy Mario plush. This was the first Mario I ever got. BDNA Winged Mario. Little Buddy Fire Mario. A Little Buddy Cat Mario plush from the Super Mario 3D World line. Similarly, to promote Super Mario 3D Land, here is Tanuki Mario, also by Little Buddy. The Sané Super Mario Galaxy Boo Mario plush. World of Nintendo Ice Mario plush, brought to us by Jack's Pacific. World of Nintendo also made this Metal Mario. And Baby Donkey Kong. For some reason, of all the characters that needed a plush, they wanted to make Baby DK. A Baby Mario plush. I asked you guys in the last Mario plush collection where this plush came from, and y'all said SK Japan. So to that I say, thank you. Similarly, we have the SK Japan Baby Luigi. Little Buddy Luigi's Mansion Polterpup. Sané All-Star Collection Poochie. A Bob-omb Buddy from World of Nintendo. I have three. My older Sané Mario Party 5 Mario. My older Sané Mario Party 5 Luigi. He doesn't exactly look the best, but that's because he's been with me since about, I want to say, 2008 or 2009, so yeah, he's old. Toy Site Cranky Kong. Toy Site Funky Kong. Here is Wario by Kelly Toy. Sané Waluigi. Sané Nabbit, meant to promote New Super Mario Bros. U, as seen by the tag. Upon editing this video, I found out that Metal Mario's footage got removed for some reason, so here he is now. This is the Sané All-Star Collection Metal Mario plush. He was one of the stars of the previous video back in 2020. Hope you're proud of yourself, Metalhead. You made me refilm the footage.
Happy!
Here is Dr. Mario, made from a Sané Mario plush. And here is Wario in his WarioWare suit. We got a Sané Wario plush, and we gave him the hat, the gloves, the shirt, the jacket, the pants, and the shoes. Here's a custom of Professor Egad from Luigi's Mansion. A custom blue Pianta plush. Arms are movable and bendable. A custom Lady Bow plush. A custom Mallow plush. Arms are movable but not bendable. A custom Gino plush. And the custom Ashley plush. Arms are bendable, and so is the neck. Kind of. Three bootlegs here. We got a bootleg green toad. Here's a light blue toad. I bought it off of Toys and Joys when that website was still alive, and apparently they had a bunch of other toad varieties, so lots of bootlegs, but they had a lot of official plush too, and I wish I could have bought the purple toad when I had the chance. An unofficial Yoshi keychain plush. Toadsworth, according to my sources, he is indeed a bootleg, but hey, even for a bootleg, he looks really good. Here's an orange monkey plush by BJ Toy Company Incorporated. While he isn't a Mario character, I still always saw him as Lanky Kong. He's one of the first plush I ever got, if not the first plush I ever got, so I felt like including him in the collection because, hey, featured him last time, may as well feature him again. Now for the plush who weren't seen in the 2020 video. Starting off, we have the Sané Mario Party 5 Toad. Yeah, I figured I'd get a little upgrade for Toad after all these years, you know? Everyone else looked new, so I figured Toad deserved an upgrade too. Sané All-Star Collection Baby Peach. Sané All-Star Collection Baby Daisy. Sané All-Star Collection Baby Rosalina. Global Holdings Princess Peach. Little Buddy Captain Toad.
Look, two Donkey Kongs!
Another Little Buddy Donkey Kong. This one's gonna be used as a stunt double. The fourth Jack-specific World of Nintendo Bob-omb Buddy. Little Buddy Luigi plush from Luigi's Mansion Dark Moon. This is the Scared Luigi and Regular Luigi. World of Nintendo Jack-specific Penguin Mario. A Mini Mario Banpresto keychain plush. A blue Yoshi from the Sané Yoshi's Island DS line, but we got him from South Korea. So he has a different style of tag, and he's got a little spot on the top of his head as if he were meant to be for a keychain. An old school Banpresto Mario plush. I have 28. Sané Dr. Mario from the Dr. Mario World set. Too bad that game no longer exists. Sané Elephant Mario plush for Super Mario Wonder. A couple of small Mini Mario keychain plush by Epoch. These plush came in the small, medium, and large varieties, but I decided to go with the small. Banpresto New Super Mario Bros. DS Blue Shell Mario. Coolest power-up in the Mario franchise, and yet we can't use it ever again. Sad. Here is a Banpresto New Super Mario Bros. DS plush of Luigi in his casino outfit. Dixie Kong, made by Takara Tomy. This plush could only be found in Japan, and I'm thankful to have her in my collection. Also by Takara Tomy, it's Unguard, the swordfish from Donkey Kong Country. Here's a half-custom, because we took a Little Buddy plush, and we made DK Jr. That's right, it is Donkey Kong Jr., aka Donkey Kong II, DK's father. Hasn't been seen in action since Mario Tennis, although you could also say he appeared in Mario Kart Tour, but not really. Similarly, a Donkey Kong plush became the one and only Funky Kong. Even comes with his surfboard, which you can attach to his feet via magnets. He is one cool Kong. Only a few customs in the hero department. First up is Goombella. Now we have Ms. Mouse. Her tail is bendable. Here is Mona from the WarioWare series. The arms are bendable. The legs are bendable. The neck is bendable. And her hat is removable. Oh yeah, and the goggles are too. Also adding Little Mac here too. I mean, yes, I know, he's from Punch-Out, but at the same time, Mario and Donkey Kong appeared in Punch-Out games, so I feel like it was only fair. Especially since Punch-Out's last game was for the Wii. The arms are bendable, and his neck can turn. The bootleggers have had a field day. This Peachette plushie, for example, is one of their creations. And she looks, good. Here's Captain Toadette. And here is Pauline. Surprising to me that this one's a bootleg because, wow, she looks really good. I mean, sheesh, could very well be official. A Disney Rattlesnake plush, but I figured I'd add him to the collection too because he looks just like Rattly from Donkey Kong Country 2. Now for... who is this? The tag says they're from Makeship, but who are they? Kinda looks like Gino, but... I don't know. Do you want to hear an absolute truth? This is Red from Everhood, and yes, they look like Geno, but no, it's not Geno. Also from BJ Toy Company, here is another Kong.
On the channel, he's known as Stanky Kong,
because he hung out in too much toxic waste, and now he stinks. From Novelty Inc., here is Slurps, aka Slurpy Kong, not a Nintendo plush, but still wanted to add her to the collection because she is a Kong on the channel. The rest of the plush are either items, bad guys, new plush, or some odd combination of the three. Let's find out for ourselves, shall we? Starting off, we have the Sane Mario Party 5 Bowser, the Little Buddy Bowser Jr. plush, the Sane All-Star Collection Dry Bowser. This was the other star of the 2020 plush collection. And he still looks as badass as always, like, wow. Sane Kamek plush. During the filming of Big Bad Lego Bowser, his wand fell off. But I think it's okay because it gives him more range to do different poses. Hashtag collectibles Bowser puppet.
That's right! I'm the Big Bad Bowser puppet! And I'm the best!
The Holy Grail himself, the Ban Presto King Bob-omb plush from the Super Mario 64 set. The first Victokai Magic Koopa plush. This one is known on the channel as Jimmy. And this is the other Victokai Magic Koopa plush. Longtime fans and even newcomers may recognize him as Jerry.
Yeah, it's me, guys. Hey, why don't I get to be in another video? Cause like I haven't been in a video forever and waiting for
Jerry,
Peach Castle.
Get out of here. Sane Ludwig von Koopa. Sane Lemmy Koopa. Sane Roy Koopa. Sane Iggy Koopa. Sane Wendy O Koopa. Sane Morton Koopa Jr. Sane Larry Koopa. Sane Boom Boom. Sane Pom Pom. Here is an SK Japan plush of Bowser Jr., but we took off his bib to make him Baby Bowser, specifically for the tyrannical tyke. Originally, the plush would vibrate if you pulled his hair. That no longer happens because the plush got wet. You can still hear the rattle inside the plush. Popco Entertainment Petey Piranha. An older Sane Mario Party 5 Bowser. This one was bought way back in the day alongside with Toad, Mario, Luigi, and the likes. And yeah, he's definitely showing his age. Victokai Magic Koopa plush. This one came to me with only one nostril. This one came with two, and we'll find out that both of these plush are actually incomplete. But one thing I'd like to point out is that both these plush can actually, strip down.
Woohoo! Let's get naked!
Little Buddy Thwomp plush. This one is actually a pillow. Little Buddy Piranha Plant plush. The stalk is bendable, and the teeth can chomp. Sane Wiggler plush. Sane Bonsai Bill plush. Sane Big Boo plush. He's also known on the channel as Teddy. Sane plush of Spike. Global Holdings Lakitu and Spiny. As you can see here. Little Buddy Fuzzy plush. Little Buddy Cheep Cheep. The Sane Pokey plush. Little Buddy Bullet Bill. Sane Mech Koopa, or Mech Koopa, or Mechatoy, or whatever you want to call him. Bad Mario Party 10 boss, you know? Anything. The strange looking World of Nintendo Jack specific Goomba plush. I already said I didn't like this plush, and I still don't. A pair of Little Buddy All-Star Collection Hammer Bros. One Sane Hammer Bro plush. Sane Buzzy Beetle. One Sane Chain Chomp plush. And three Little Buddy Chain Chomps to go with him. Sane Porky Puffer. Sane Paratroopa, complete with the tag. Global Holdings Paratroopa.
Oy, they really don't pay me enough for this job.
Sane Koopa Troopa plush. A Little Buddy Koopa Troopa plush. There's a slight difference in the two, mostly in the eyes, but if we count them all together, we have six. A Global Holdings plush of Koopa Troopa. Can't believe this is a Global Holdings plush, but here we are. They've come a long way. Goldie Marketing Koopa Troopa. A pair of Little Buddy Bob-ombs. We have three Bob-ombs, one of them being from Global Holdings. A Banpresto Goomba with sound. A Banpresto Galoomba.
We have two, but this one still has his hang string. We did have one on the other Galoomba, and it even had a suction cup, but it fell off.
My first Goomba plush, this one was from Sane. Since then, we managed to acquire three Little Buddy Goombas, three Little Buddy All-Star Collection Goombas, one Sane Paragoomba, one Popco Goomba that I lost for several years before we found him under a toy chest, one Global Holdings Grand Goomba, the rare Sane Monty Mole plush, a couple of Banpresto Paratroopa keychain plush, a Sane blooper plush,
combined with two Little Buddy bloopers, we have three,
the Victokai Monty Mole plush, the hashtag collectibles Piranha Plant Puppet.
So nice, I had to buy them twice.
One Global Holding Shy Guy, plus three Little Buddy Shy Guys, brings our total up to four. A Banpresto keychain plush for New Super Mario Bros. DS, this is of Spike Top. A Banpresto Bullet Bill plush, famously used by the cute Mario Brothers, he is known there as the Beep Beep Coming Through Guy. His hands were originally attached to his body, but as a kid I cut them off because I wanted him to have more free range with his arms, especially if he wants to hold something.
A little keychain plush of Blooper from the same line as Spike Top and the Paratroopas.
A Banpresto plush of Pidget from the Super Mario All-Stars line. A Sane Boo. A Global Holdings Boo. A Popco Balloon Boo plush. One Little Buddy All-Star Collection Boo.
Five World of Nintendo Jack-specific Boos.
A Little Buddy Dry Bones.
I have seven.
Here is the Victokai Charge and Chuck plush. As you can see, the helmet has stickers on it, two stars on the side, and one long stripe going all the way from the front to the back. The inside of the helmet has a weird sponge-like material with glue on it, and the mouth guard is immovable. A Kelly Toy Donkey Kong plush. I wanted him to look more like the original Donkey Kong from the 1981 classic. Banpresto Mario Kart Wii Blue Shell plush. Technically not an enemy, but he may as well be at this point, especially after the Super Mario Bros. Movie. I mean, come on. I'm not sure who this fella is. They say he's Mr. L. Not sure who exactly this Mr. L fella is, but it was originally supposed to be a Sane plush, I think. Or was it a Little Buddy plush? Global Holdings? He's Mr. L, the Green Thunder.
He's Luigi? No, he is not Luigi.
A custom plush of Fawful, who has no arms. A custom plush of Cammy Koopa. Here is Mac
Clay Morton!
Wait, what? Oh yeah, right. From Super Mario RPG. Now, I get why they renamed him to Clay Morton, but at the same time, like, the original name was just so iconic, so I consider this to be Clay Morton. With the bendable body. And the little guy on top is Mac. I mean, he looks like a Mac. He doesn't look like a Clay Morton, but that's just me. His arms are also bendable, and so are the legs. Here is Mimi from Super Paper Mario. The interesting thing about this plush is you can remove her hair. Inside of the plush are two magnets which can attach to her spider legs. Now for the Brutals, starting with Topper. You can remove his hat. He also came with two other hats as well. We forgot to give him hair though, so he looks like an egg. Oops. Next is Spewart. Hat is also removable, and his arms are bendable. Here is Harriet. Her head can turn, the arms can move, the arms are bendable, and she came with two little spike balls. She couldn't hold them in her hair, but the plush still came with them, and her hat is also removable. As you can see, it's bouncing around a lot. Last of the Brutals, we have Rango. His hat is also removable to reveal his fabulous hair. Both the arms and the legs are bendable. And movable, and his neck can turn too.
I just wish Nintendo would use these guys a little more. I mean, I can't believe they're going with the Sonic route of abandoning new characters, but geez.
Here is King Boo from Luigi's Mansion. He's huge, can barely hold him in my hand, and yeah. Here is the Dark Star. And here is some of his evil energy just radiating off of him, which you can attach to his back. Via these little buttons. And yes, here is King K. Rool. Feel like it would be a disservice not to include him. Arms are bendable, and the crown has a magnet inside. A supposed plush by Banpresto, meant to promote New Super Mario Bros. DS, it is a Koopa Troopa on all fours.
The reason he's in the bootleg section is because in that game there are no Koopas that walk on all fours, and he looks more like a shell creeper, but hey, still a cool plush. A giant bootleg blue chain chomp with an actual chain. A bootlegged Donkey Kong by Gosh International PLC. I just think he looks really stupid, and that's why he's in the collection. A bootleg Boomerang Bro plush, said to be by Sonaco. The same brand also made these two Dry Bones plush. Here is the small one, and the big one. At the time, this was the only way to get a Dry Bones plush, was to own one of these two. Specifically the big one. A bootleg Big Shy Guy plush. A bootleg Red Koopa Troopa plush. A fake Lakitu plush, which looks really, really bad. The spiny looks okay. A bootlegged King Koopa plush, who actually looks really nice, and for a bootleg, he is fantastic. Like, wow. When it comes to my stance on bootlegs, I want more of this, less of this. These are Zoomania turtles made by One Stop Shop, but they looked like Bombshell Koopas from Super Mario Land. As such, I decided they're part of Bowser's army. And lastly, before we get into the new plush, here is an IKEA dragon from Min and Drake. The character of Dragalar, yes, he is indeed based on Gobblegut, at least in my eyes, but the character himself was not made by me. The character was made by Mr. Gojira 95, so go check him out, go send him my kind regards. And this plush is a monster. He is huge, he's got big old wings, he's got a long, long body, he's like 6 feet tall. Not even kidding, he is huge. Couple of Little Buddy warp pipes, a Banpresto Mario Kart Wii banana peel, a large banana peel by Good Stuff. I have three. The infamous question mark block by Banpresto. I say infamous because on the channel he is known as Biggie the Block. He is a sentient question mark block, and he's a big, big middle finger to all those bosses based off of enemies. And yes, he does make sound. Here is an old school variant of the question block. That also makes sound. A Sané All-Star Collection.
Fire Flower.
Several mini Banpresto keychain plush. Three mushrooms, a Fire Flower, a mini mushroom, and two Starmen. Banpresto Mario Kart Wii Golden Mushroom. A Tomy Club Mochi Mochi Red Shell. A Good Stuff Green Shell plush. The Banpresto Mario Kart Wii Thundercloud. Banpresto Mario Kart Wii Starman. The Banpresto Mega Mushroom plush. And the Tomy Club Mochi Mochi Bowser Shell plush. A custom Starman. A trio of magic wands belonging to Ashley, Cammy, and Kamek. Unofficial boomerang plush that went with the Boomerang Bro. A couple of Poltergust 5000s. These are actually unofficial, the real Luigi plush still have theirs intact. But what about the new guys? Let's find out, shall we? Starting with the Banpresto Mega Monty Mole plush.
I am the greatest.
You sure are, buddy. Another Little Buddy Thwomp pillow. A Tomy Club Mochi Mochi Thwomp. From the same line, here is a giant Shy Guy. Another Banpresto Goomba with sound. Sané All-Star Collection Spiny. A Little Buddy plush of Monty Mole.
I have five.
A bunch of Little Buddy All-Star Collection Boos.
I have eight.
A Banpresto Green Paratroopa plush. A Sané Bob-omb. And a pair of Bob-ombs from Global Holdings. Sané Blue Virus. Sané Red Virus. And the Sané Yellow Virus, all for Dr. Mario World, which no longer exists. Another Banpresto Spike Top. Quite a few Little Buddy All-Star Collection Shy Guys.
I have seven.
And a few Little Buddy All-Star Collection Goombas.
I have 12.
Also add a couple of Little Buddy Paragoombas, and a couple of tiny Banpresto Keychain Goombas. Here is the Victokai Super Koopa, from Super Mario World. A Global Holdings Cheap Cheap I saved from a thrift store. A Little Buddy Piranha Plant plush. Hammer Brothers, specifically Sané and Little Buddy. Four Sané Hammer Bros and one Little Buddy Hammer Bro. And a Victokai Magikoopa plush. This one's the complete version because it has the extra little circles on his wand. A Sané Hammer Bro plush turned into the Army Hammer Bro from Super Princess Peach. A Little Buddy Shy Guy turned into the Pastry Chef Shy Guy from Mario Kart Tour. We have the Koopa Clown Car. The propeller is not only bendable, but it can also spin around. Here come the Tiki Tak Tribe from Donkey Kong Country Returns. All their arms are bendable, starting with Kalimba, the Maraca triplets, who may not have arms, but they all have bendable stocks. Gongo. Banjo Bottom. What a strange name for a tiki. Wacky Pipes. The names just keep getting better and better for these tikis. Xylobone. Okay, that name's actually pretty good. Cordian. Here is a custom plush of Bogmire from Luigi's Mansion. A Sniffit. Bootleg Dark Bowser plush. Bootleg Bowser Jr. Super Mario Sunshine plush? It actually looks pretty good. The bib looks really nice and the paintbrush is bendable. I mean, for a bootleg, this looks really good. Here are some unofficial Trotten Piranha plants from Super Mario Wonder. I have two. Unofficial Fire Spike. And an unofficial Ninji. I have two. And finally, the last plush in my collection.
I am the Great Wart. Ha ha ha!
That's right, it's Wart or Mamu from Super Mario Bros. 2 / Doki Doki Panic. He is a big boy. Crown is removable, the arms are bendable, necklace and robe are also removable, and he's just a really nice plush. So, this is my updated Mario plush collection. Yes, there's been quite a few new additions to the cast since 2020, but gotta say, I'm pretty proud of how the collection turned out. When it comes to looking for these plush online, I recommend eBay or Mercari. But when it comes to shops in person, I recommend Target, GameStop, Barnes & Noble, heck, even Walmart. I've seen Chain Chomp plush in there before. And I can't believe Super Mario Bros. Is gonna turn 40 in 2025. I mean, jeez, it feels like yesterday it was the 35th anniversary, but here we are. The Super Mario Bros. Series was one of the first series of games I ever played, and that's why the series means so much to me, to the point where this is the second largest plush collection I own, second only to the Pokemon. And I know I always have the Q&A section at the end, but this time I want to hear from you. Who's your favorite character from the Mario series? Got a favorite game? What about a least favorite game? Maybe a least favorite character? Who do you main in Mario Kart? And why is the golden mushroom such a bad item in Mario Kart anyway? Like, I want a bullet bill or a lightning bolt or a star, not a golden mushroom. But regardless, I'm glad the Mario series has lasted as long as it did. Well, I've run out of stuff to say, so until next time, this is LuigiFanQuado1 signing out, saying see you guys later. Remember to like and subscribe for future content. Remember to ring that bell, all that good stuff. And as always, have yourselves a fantastic day.
How adorable. Soon you're all gonna end up just like Blue Boy over there.